Hello students, I welcome all of you to the YouTube channel of SRT. Now today I am going to teach you first chapter of your second semester in mathematics, that is your chapter number 10, division of polynomials. This video is only for standard 8 students of state board, Maharashtra state board I mean to say. In this video I am going to explain you practice set number 10.1 and the remaining exercises I will be teaching you in the remaining videos on this channel itself. Do subscribe to the channel to get all the latest updates on this particular channel. You guys are free to share this video with even those students who are not a part of SRT so that everyone can benefit from it. Chalo, now without wasting more time, let's start with practice set number 10.1. Come on.
Okay, so students, let's start with chapter number 10 now, that is division of polynomials. In this particular lecture, I will try to cover the entire chapter with each and every sum that is there in the practice set. Okay, let me share the questions with you now. Okay, I hope the questions are visible to everyone. Now, this is your practice set number 10.1. Now, there are two practice sets in this particular chapter. Your first practice set, here we are going to study how to divide a polynomial by a monomial. अभी मोनोमियल का मतलब होता है दैट देयर विल बी अ सिंगल टर्म. ओके, जस्ट एन एग्जांपल आई विल टेल यू व्हाट एग्जैक्टली अ मोनोमियल इज. इफ यू गो टू सी ऑल द डिवाइजर्स दैट आई एम हाइलाइटिंग ओवर हियर, ऑल दीज आर नथिंग बट सिंगल टर्म. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्सरसाइज वी स्टडी हाउ टू डिवाइड अ पॉलिनोमियल बाय अ मोनोमियल एंड योर नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ टू डिवाइड अ पॉलिनोमियल बाय अ बाइनोमियल. बाइनोमियल मीन्स योर डिवाइजर विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू टर्म्स. ओके, चल नाउ बिफोर वी बिगिन, फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन यू फ्यू टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू डिविजन. लेट्स से इफ आई हैव 40 divide by 10. Now everyone knows how this is to be done. What I will be doing over here is I will write 40, I will write 10 over here. 10, how many gives you 40? That is what you ask yourself. 10 fours is 40. So I write 40 and this is the answer that I get. Now whatever number is written over here, this is your answer of your division, which is called as quotient. This particular number that remains at the last is called as your remainder. The number that gets divided is called as your dividend, and the number with which you are dividing is called as your divisor. So regarding division of numbers, you guys are aware about it. Here we will study how to do the division process when number and variable both are simultaneously present. Okay, I'll directly start with the sums, and as and when required, I'll go on explain you the concepts also simultaneously. Okay, chalo, let's begin now. First, I'll divide my page into two parts over here so that it becomes easier for you all to understand. And I'll also maximize the screen over here. Okay, now the first question that you have over here, first one, it is 21m square divided by 7m. Now, in your answer, this is the way your answer needs to be written in the exam also. First, you will mention your dividend and your divisor. So, I will say that my dividend over here is 21m square and your divisor is 7m. Then you start with your division process. Okay. So, this is what you will be doing. 21m square and here I will write 7m. Now, there has to be something called as working that is required. Okay, abhi this particular working that I am showing you, you have to do it in the exam also. It is compulsory. It is not optional. You are not going to do it on the last page or anywhere. Okay, it is a part of your solution. So, what you are going to do is you have to take your divisor. Your divisor is what? 7m into dash gives you, you have to take the first term of your dividend over here. My first term of the dividend is 21m square. So now you are supposed to ask yourself that this 7m, with what am I supposed to multiply so that I will get 21m square? Okay, now take one thing at a time, that is number first and then comes the variable. So when I talk about the number over here, it is 7 and my required quantity is 21. So 7 into what will give you 21? Very obvious, 7 into 3 gives you 21. So I write this 3 over here. Now come to the variable part. Variable part is m over here and my requirement is m square. So m into what will give you m square? Very obvious, m into m gives you m square. So your divisor needs to get multiplied with 3m. If it gets multiplied with 3m, you will get 21m square. The number that you get over here, you have to write it as the quotient, and the number that you get over here, you will write below the dividend. Is that clear? Okay. So when I write this, I will get 21m square, and then you will leave a line. One line you will always leave for sign change, and 3m you write up. So 7m into 3m gives you 21m square. Now sign of this 21m square is positive. If there is no sign, by default you take it as a positive number, and you are always supposed to change the sign, and that new sign you will write on the line which is left over there. Okay, so whenever you write the number below your dividend, whatever number you write, you have to invert the sign. Plus will become minus, minus will become plus. Okay, so 21m square minus 21m square, it will get cancelled and the answer will be equal to 0. Clear? Now 0 becomes your remainder over here. I'll just shorten my line which I had done for working. Okay, after you finish your answer, it is compulsory to write your quotient and your remainder. So in this case, my quotient is 3m and remainder in this case is going to be equal to 0. It is not compulsory that remainder is always going to come 0. Okay, so this becomes your first sum. Clear? I hope things are clear over here. Now I go to question number 2. Just give me a minute. Okay, coming to question number 2, your question number 2 is 40a cube divided by minus 10a. Now you know what is to be done. Sabse pehle, you are going to write your dividend. In this case, your dividend is 40a cube. Then you will write your divisor. Your divisor in this case is minus 10a. Clear? Then you will do a separate column for working. Again, I repeat, it is not your rough work. It has to be a part of your solution. Okay. I'll just keep some more space for working over here so that things don't get congested. Okay. Now, okay, your division sign over here. Your dividend is 40a cube, which I write over here, and your divisor is minus 10a, which I make a mention over here. Now you have to take your divisor minus 10a into multiply by something so that your target is to get 40a cube. Whatever is the first term of your dividend, that has to be the target over here. Okay. As I told you, go one by one. Sabse pehle you talk about the number. My number over here is minus 10a and I want 40. One thing everyone knows that 10 into 4 is going to give you 40. But over here I have minus 10. And what I want is plus 40. Matlab mera sign bhi change hona chahiye. Because my sign has to change, I will multiply by a negative number. Now see, minus 10 into minus 4 will give you plus 40, which is the required thing. So number part is done. Now come to the variable part. Here it is A and my target is to get AQ. A into what will give you AQ? Very obvious, A into A square gives you AQ. Clear? Here the property that we are using is a raised to m into a raised to n is a raised to m plus n. So whenever the variable gets multiplied, their index gets added. Okay, abhi idhar a ka koi bhi index nahi hai. So by default we take it as 1. Okay, so a raised to 1 into a raised to 2. So index will become 1 plus 2 by this formula which you have studied in previous standard. Okay. So as I told you, whatever number you get over here, that is a part of your quotient. So in my quotient, I will say it is minus 4a square. And the answer that I get is 40a cube. I will leave one line for sign change. Okay. this 40 a cube is a positive number, that becomes negative. 40 a cube gets cancelled and your remainder is zero. Finally, as I told you, you will be writing your quotient and remainder. So my quotient is minus 4 a square, and coincidentally in this sum also my remainder is zero. I hope the first two sums are clear to you. Okay, now I proceed ahead. I'll quickly erase the entire thing so that we have enough space to do the remaining sums. Okay, at a time, we will do only two sums over here. Okay, now coming to question number three. Question number three, your question is minus 48 p raised to 4. This thing is getting divided by minus 9 p square. Answer. You take your dividend. Your dividend is what? Minus 48 p raised to 4. Then you take your divisor. Your divisor in this case is what? Minus 9 p square. Okay. Now, you have to do the division process. So here I will write minus 48 p raised to 4 and my divisor minus 9 p square. Then I'll prepare one rough column over here for working. It is a part of your solution. You are not supposed to do it as a rough work anything. Okay. It will carry marks. So here I will write my divisor, which is minus 9 p square. I need to multiply by something and my target is to get minus 48 p raised to 4. Okay. Now the number that I'll be writing over here will be a part of your quotient. Now look over here. Going one at a time. Sabse pehle I am trying to adjust my number. My number is minus 9. And my target is to get minus 48. Now 9 ke table mein 48 nahi aane wala hai. So whenever you have such a type of a problem where you don't have an exact multiple, what is to be done is you directly write the number that is required. So I require 48. Okay. But this 9 into 48, this 9, I don't want, I need only 48. So whichever number you don't want, you write it in the denominator. You can cross check what I am trying to do. 9 into 48 upon 9 when I will do. Ye 9 to cancel hoke. Eventually I am getting 48 only. So this process is to be done when you don't have an exact multiple. So what you will be doing, whatever number is required, you blindly write it over here. Okay. And whatever number is over here, you write it in the denominator so that ultimately it is going to get cancelled. Or ye jo number aata hai na, this has to be in the reduced form. Okay. Now 48 and 9 both goes in 3 ka table. Okay. So it is compulsory to cancel by 3 and get the answer in reduced form. So 3 threes are, and here I will say 3 ones are 3. 4 mein se 3 gaya, remainder will be 1. The next number becomes 18. So I will write 16. So what I eventually get is 16 upon 3. Now 16 upon 3, I cannot reduce it further. So number part mein I have written 16 upon 3. Let's talk about the sign. This is a negative number and my answer should also be negative. Okay. So very obvious, this negative into positive is going to give me a negative number. So sign change nahi karna hai. So I'll multiply by a positive number. So your number part is done. Now let's talk about the variable. Here I have p square and my target is to get p raised to 4. So very obvious, p square into p square is going to give you p raised to 4. So what I have got is 16 upon 3 p square. And your answer, the after multiplication becomes minus 48 p raised to 4. As I told you, leave one line for sign change. It is a negative number. Make it positive. Now minus 48 plus 48, it will get cancelled. Your remainder will be equal to 0. So I write my quotient over here as 16 upon 3 p square. And your remainder, I will be writing it as 0. This becomes your answer. I hope things are clear. Okay. Now going to question number 4. Question number 4 is also similar. Again, you will have a problem with adjusting the number part. Okay. First, you write your dividend. Your dividend over here is 40 m raised to 5. And your divisor is 30 MQ. Okay, I'll just clear the screen a bit. Okay, now you do your division process. What you want is 40, the dividend is 40 m raised to 5, your divisor is 30 m3. Then, as you know, we have to do the working over here. Working is a part of your sum. Okay, working is compulsory, it has to be shown in the exam also. Okay, now working mein I will say 30 m3. I will multiply by something and my target is to get 40 m raised to 5. Now, as I told you, first we will adjust the number part. Number part mein mere paas 30 hai and what I want is 40. Now, 30 ke table mein 40 nahi aane wala hai. Okay, so what I will do, whatever number is required, you directly write it as it is. And for this 30 now, in order to be cancelled, I will write it in the denominator. So ultimately, you can see what you are trying to get over here. 30 into 40 upon 30. 30, 30 cancel, okay. Eventually, toh mera answer 40 rehne wala hai. So whenever there is no clear multiple, whatever is the required number, you put it down in the numerator and divisor in order to get it cancelled, you write it in the denominator. Then as I told you in the previous sum also, this number has to be in the reduced form. Okay, they both goes in 10 ka table, or you can say you can cancel 0, 0 over there. So what I'm left with is 4/3. So your final number that you get is 4/3. Okay, number part adjust ho gaya. Now here it is m raised to 3. What I want is m raised to 5. So I'll multiply by m square. So eventually the number that I have to multiply is 4/3 m square. And iska answer will come 40 m raised to 5. Leave a line for sign change. Here I will write minus and my remainder is 0. Is that clear? Then you need to write your quotient and remainder. I will talk about my quotient first. My quotient is 4/3 m square. And the remainder that you get in this case is 0. Okay, I hope question number 3 and question number 4 is clear. Going to the next two questions now. Okay, now question number 5. Now here we start dividing a binomial by a monomial. Matlab your dividend is going to have more than one term. So in such cases, what you are supposed to do, let's see that. Sabse pehle I'll write my dividend. Your dividend is what? 5x cube minus 3x square. Then you take your divisor. Divisor is x square. Okay, now whenever your dividend has more than one term, it is compulsory to adjust your dividend in standard form. Now, what do we mean by standard form? Pay attention. Suppose if I have x square plus x raised to 4 plus x cube plus 3x plus 1. Suppose agar ye mera dividend rehta, just an example I'm giving you. You have to search for the highest index. My highest index is 4. So that particular term will come first. 4 ke baad in descending order 3. Then square. Then x term. And then the constant. This is what we mean by standard form. Standard form ka matlab hota hai, you have to arrange your dividend starting from the maximum index and then go in descending order. Is that clear? Abhi in this case, if I go to see, either if I go to see my mera jo ye dividend hai na, my highest index is what? 3. 3 ke baad mein 2 aaya, chalega, descending order mein hai. So there is no problem at all. Later on, when my divisor will become a binomial in my next practice set, over there I will teach you how to insert the missing terms in the dividend. Inserting missing terms in the dividend is not required when your divisor is a monomial. Clear? So I'm not talking about that right now. You just have to arrange your dividend in descending order of index. Here it is already in descending order, so no need to change anything. Okay. Now, okay, I'll just write it a bit neatly. One second. Okay, so here you have 5x cube minus 3x square, and here you have x square. Now, I will be doing one working column over here as we have done in all the sums so far. So here I will write the working, and working will go in multiple steps. So in the first step, I will take my divisor is x square, multiply by something, and your target will always be to get the first term of the dividend. My first term of the dividend is 5x cube. Is that clear? Okay. Abhi, let's see. Number we will talk about first. X square ke saath mein there is no number involved. If there is no number, by default we take the number as 1. Okay. 1 into what will give you 5? Because I want 5, I will write 5 over here. There is no sign change required because there is no negative sign anywhere over here. Okay. Now comes the variable part. X square hai, mere ko x cube chahiye. So very obvious, x square into x will give you x cube. Whatever number I have written over here, that will go in the quotient. Okay. So here I write 5x. On multiplication, we come to know the answer that we get is 5x cube. Now I will leave one line. Okay. And I will change the sign. Ye number positive. That becomes negative. So very obvious, 5x cube, 5x cube gets cancelled and the sum does not get over in this case. Okay. This number is left, which will come down as it is. Okay. Take the number with the sign. So minus 3x square comes down. Clear? Okay. Now, your second step of the working, again, you take your divisor and now your required quantity is this. So multiply by something, what you should get is minus 3x square. Okay. Take the number part. Either x square ke saath mein there is no number means the number is 1. 1 into what will give you minus 3? 1 into minus 3 will give you minus 3 because obviously there is a sign change required. I multiply by a negative number. And ye jo x square hai, same x square is here also. So variable mein nothing needs to be multiplied. Variable is as it is. So I just multiply by minus 3. So this minus 3 will go and get attached to the quotient up. So here I write minus 3 and what I get is minus 3x square. Leave a line for sign change. Minus will become plus. Then minus 3x square plus 3x square cancel. Remainder is 0. Now I don't have enough space over here to write the quotient and remainder. So I am just writing it. Just give me a minute. Okay. Main idhar baju mein quotient aur remainder likh raha hu, but you have to write below the sum. Okay. So my quotient is 5x minus 3. And my remainder in this case is going to be equal to 0. I hope the sum is clear. Now going to question number 6. Question number 6 is what? 8p cube minus 4p square. This entire thing is getting divided by 2p square. Answer. First, you take the dividend. Your dividend is what now? 8p cube minus 4p square. Then you take your divisor. Your divisor is 2p square. Now, sabse pehle, what did I tell you? Since my dividend has more than one term over here, I will first check whether the numbers are in ascending order of the index or no. So starting with 3, then there is 2. So it is okay. It is in descending order. No need to change anything. Okay. Then one column I will draw for the working part. And I'll start my division process. So over here, my dividend is. Okay, so this is what you have. Take your first step of working. I give a heading over here, working. First step, 2p square. I need to multiply by something in order to get my first term of the dividend. Your target is always to get the first term of the dividend. Okay. So this is what I want. Now, kisse multiply karoge? Sabse pehle number dekho. 2 ko mere ko kya banane ka hai? 2 needs to be made as 8. So 2 into 4 will give you 8. P square ke jage pe I want P cube. So P square into what will give me P cube? P square into P will give me P cube. Whatever I multiply goes in the quotient over here. Okay. So 4P, I'll write 8P cube. Okay, leave a line for sign change. I'll write minus, ye cancel ho gaya. Second number comes down as it is. So minus 4p square will come down as it is. Now I will take the second step of my working. So second step mein I will say, again you take your divisor 2p square, multiply by something, and my target now is to get minus 4p square. So here I write minus 4p square. Abhi 2, kisse multiply karoge to minus 4 milega. 2, you have to multiply by minus 2. There is a sign change required, hence you multiply by a negative number. And p square needs to be kept as p square only. So variable is not supposed to change in this case. Okay, so here I write minus 2 and the answer that I get is minus 4p square. Leave a line for sign change, plus ye cancel, okay, remainder becomes 0. Then very obvious, you have to write your quotient and remainder. My quotient is 4p minus 2 and my remainder in this case is 0. Is that clear? Okay. Going to the next two questions now. That is your question number 7 and question number 8. Okay, let me draw margins. Okay, question number 7. First, I write the question 2y cube plus 4y square plus 3. This entire thing gets divided by 2y square. In my answer, sabse pehle I will write my dividend. My dividend is 2y cube plus 4y square plus 3. Then your divisor is 2y square. I need to draw a working column. It is a part of the sum, not a part of rough work or anything like that. It will carry mark. You have to show that in the exam also. Okay. Theek hai. Chalo. Now, as I told you, dividend has more than one term. So the first thing that you will check is whether the index are in descending order or not. So now the index 3 hai, 2 hai, and then there is a constant term whose index we consider as 0. Okay, so 3 to 0 descending order mein hai, no problem at all. Agar mera divisor, if it was a binomial, like you will be having it in the next exercise, either I would have introduced a missing term 0y, which is not required when your divisor is a monomial. So insertion of missing term is there only when your divisor is binomial or if it contains more than one term, binomial, trinomial, so on and so forth. Okay, either aapko khali check karne ka hai ki descending order mein hai ki nahi hai. Okay, chal. Starting with the division process now. 2y cube plus 4y square plus 3. And over here I have 2y square. Okay. Now, working ka first step, 2y, I will multiply by something and your target is always to get the first term of the dividend. My first term of the dividend is 2y cube. As I told you, we will go step by step. Sabse pehle you need to adjust your number. Either 2 hai aur mere ko 2 hi chahiye. So number mein nothing needs to be changed. So I don't need to multiply by anything. But if I check my variable, y has to become y cube. Okay, so y ko kisse multiply karege to y cube milega, obviously y square. Okay, whatever number you get over here will come as a part of quotient. So here I will write y square. The answer that I get on multiplication is 2y cube. Leave one line for sign change. Okay, minus will come, ye cancel ho jayega. Remaining entire dividend you have to write down as it is. Okay, so now I will write 4y square plus 3. Then comes the second step of your working. 2y, which is your divisor, multiply by something. As I told you, target is always to get the first term of the dividend. Now the first term of the dividend is 4y square. So here I will write 4y square. Clear? Now think, 2y ko kisse multiply karege? 2 ko kisse multiply karege to 4 milega. 2 I will multiply it by 2 and then y, in order to make it y square, I will multiply by y. Whatever number I get, write it over here, and obviously the number is positive, so I write plus 2y. The answer that I get is 4y square. Leave a line for sign change. Ye cancel ho gaya. Plus 3 I write down as it is. Okay, now you will go for the third step of the working. You will think 2y into what will give you 3. Abhi ek condition suno. Whenever the index over here is more than the required thing, you cannot perform your division. What I mean to say is ki abhi idhar dekho, ye y ka kuch bhi index nahi hai. Matlab your index is 1. And here there is no variable. When there is no variable, we consider it as y raised to 0, because anything raised to 0 is 1. Okay, so can I say index over here 1 is more than 0? Yes, so you cannot perform your division further. Whatever number remains, that becomes your remainder. Okay, matlab ye jo y hai na, isko main kisse bhi multiply karu, I cannot remove y. Getting my point? Understood? Okay, so ye third step aayega hi nahi. 3 becomes your remainder. Then very obvious, you need to write your quotient and remainder. I don't have much space over here to write it below the sum. You have to write it below the sum. Main idhar side mein likh leta hu. My quotient is y square plus 2y and my remainder is 3. Now going to question number 8. Question number 8 kya hai? 21x raised to 4 minus 14x square plus 7x. The whole thing gets divided by 7x cube. So first you will write your dividend. Your dividend is 21x raised to 4 minus 14x square plus 7x. Then go to your divisor. Your divisor is 7x cube. Okay. Now performing the division. 21x raised to 4 minus 14x square plus 7x. As I told you, aapko pehle check karne ka hai whether dividend mein the terms are arranged in descending order of index or no. Check karo, ye 4 hai, then 2 hai, kuch nahi hai, matlab 1 hai. So 4 to 1 descending order mein hai, no problem at all. Abhi either there is no term having an index 3. Okay, so if the divisor was not a monomial, means agar divisor binomial, trinomial, ya ise kuch hota, means more than one term, I would have introduced 0x cube. Here I would have introduced 0x, and last mein I would have introduced constant, which I will be teaching you in the next exercise. Insertion of missing terms is not necessary, or it should not be done when your divisor is a monomial. Is that clear? That is required only if your divisor is a binomial or more than two terms. Okay. Okay. Now, 7x cube is your divisor. Now, again, I draw that column for working, as you already know. Going to the first step of my working, you have to give a heading over there, working. Okay. My first step, your your target is to get 21 ko mere ko 21 banane ka hai. So by what I will multiply by 3. X cube ko x raised to 4 banane ka hai. So I'll multiply by x. So whatever number you get over here goes as a part of quotient. So this will be 3x 21 x raised to 4. Okay, leave a line for some. This will become negative. Ye to cancel ho gaya. Pura ka pura remaining dividend you will copy down as it is. Okay, so I have minus 14x square plus 7x. Abhi agar aap log dekhoge, okay, students, there was some network error and hence I'm recording this particular part again. Please excuse me for that. Okay, so now students, we have got this particular thing jo maine niche copy kiya tha. Now if you go to observe over here ki aapka jo remainder nahi, dividend ka jo first term hai, the index is 2 and divisor ka index is 3. As soon as in your dividend the index becomes less than the divisor, you are supposed to stop your division process, because x cube can never give you x square. So this whole thing becomes your remainder. Again, I repeat, Since the index over here is less than the divisor, you will stop with your division process. So in this case, there is only one step over here. So you will say that your quotient is 3x and your remainder over here is minus 14x square plus 7x. Okay. I hope these two sums are clear. Now we go to the last two sums, that is question number 9 and question number 10. Okay. Question number 9. Your question says 6x raised to 5 minus 4x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 2x squared. The whole thing gets divided by 2x squared. So as you very well know, sabse pehle you will write your dividend. Your dividend in this case is going to be what? 6x raised to 5 minus 4. Your dividend will be 6x raised to 5 minus 4x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 2x square. Then your divisor in this case is 2x square. Excuse me, my video was not working for last 10-15 seconds. Okay. Chalo. Now starting with your division. Sabse pehle, you write your dividend. Entire dividend you will copy down as it is. As I've already explained you, in your dividend, you are first supposed to check whether the terms are in descending order or no. You are not supposed to insert any missing term when your divisor is a monomial. Okay, so since the terms are already in descending order, you are not supposed to change anything. Then over here, I will be doing the working part. You have to give a heading working. Working is a part of your sum. Do not put it as your rough work or anything. Your divisor, you write 2x square. You need to multiply by something. Your target is always to get the first term of the dividend. So the first term of the dividend, you will be writing it over there. So which I write it as 6x raised to 5. Sabse pehle, first thing, you check the number. Number is 2. 2, I want to make it 6. So very obvious, you need to multiply by 3. And x square, to make it x raised to 5, I need to multiply x cube. Okay, whatever number you get over here goes as a part of your quotient. So in the quotient, I will write 3x cube. Answer that I get is 6x raised to 5. Clear? Then I will leave a line and put a horizontal line. Line you are leaving for sign change. So I take minus, rest entire dividend you will copy down as it is. Okay. So the remaining dividend that I will write down is minus 6x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 12x square. Go to the second step of your working. Your divisor is 2x square. Multiply by something. As I told you, your target is always to get the first term of the dividend, which you will be writing it over here. So that is minus 6x raised to 4. Now 2 into what will give you minus 6? Obviously minus 3, sign change karna hai, so you multiply by a negative number. X square into what will give you x raised to 4? Very obvious, x square into x square gives you x raised to 4. Whatever number you write over here goes as a part of your quotient. Okay, so there I will write minus 3x square, which gives me minus 6x raised to 4. Then leave a line for sign change. This minus will become plus. Then you consider only the new sign, minus 6 plus 6 gets cancelled. Remaining dividend you will copy down as it is. So I copy down 8x cube. Just give me a minute, students. Okay, yeah, so 8x cube plus 12x square. Okay, go to the next step of your working. 2x square multiply by something in order to get your first term of your dividend is 8x cube. So I write over here 8x cube. You will multiply by 4 in order to get 8, and x square ko x cube banane ke liye you multiply by x. Okay, clear? So whatever number I write over here goes as a part of your quotient. So in the quotient I write plus 4x, and here I will write 8x cube. leave a line for sign change. Then minus 8x cube will get cancelled. What I am left with is plus 12x square. I don't have enough space over here, and hence I'm writing it like that. You are supposed to write it one below the other. So now the number that I'm left with is 12x square. So again, I take my divisor 12x square, multiply by something, and now your target is to get 12x square. Your variable part is exactly the same. So variable mein kuch bhi multiply nahi hoga. 2 ko 12 banane ka hai. So very obvious, you multiply by 6. This 6 goes as a part of your quotient. So here in quotient, I will write plus 6. And here I will write 12x square. Very obvious, ye cut ho ke, remainder will be equal to 0. I don't have enough space, so main idhar hi specify karta hu. This is your quotient, and this 0 becomes your remainder. Very obvious, you have to write below separately what is your quotient and what is your remainder. Okay, then I go to the last sum which you are having now, that is your question number 10. Question number 10. 25m raised to 4 minus 15m cube plus 10m plus 8. This entire thing gets divided by 5m cube. You first talk about your dividend. Your dividend in this case is 25m raised to 4 minus 15m cube plus 10m plus 8. Then your divisor in this case is 5m cube. As you very well know, you will be drawing a working column. Again, I repeat, aapko pehle check karna hai whether your dividend, in your dividend, whether the index are in descending form or no. If I go to see 4, 3, nothing means 1 and constant means 0. So 4, 3, 1, 0, index are there in descending order, so no need to rearrange anything. Again, I repeat, agar divisor is your monomial, no need to insert any missing term. Missing term matlab either 0m square insert karne ka zarurat nahi hai. That is only when your divisor is a binomial or if it contains more than two terms. So you start with your division process. I write my entire dividend first as it is. Okay, and here it is 5m cube. First step in your working, 5m cube multiply by something and you have to get your first term of your dividend. Your target is always to get the first term of the dividend. So this number I have copied over here. Sabse pehle you talk about the number part. Number part mein if I go to see, I have 5 and I want to make it 25. 5 into 5 will give you 25. So I write 5 over here, and m cube to make it m raised to 4, I need to multiply by m. Whatever number I write over here goes as a part of your quotient. Okay, so here I write 5m. On multiplication, I have seen that I am getting 25m raised to 4. Leave a line for sign change. Minus, this will get cancelled. Remaining entire dividend you will copy down as it is. Okay, so minus 15m cube plus 10m plus 8. So what you have is 5m cube. Now I need to multiply by something in order to get minus 15m cube. Clear? Okay. Number part dekho, 5 ko mere ko minus 15 banane ka hai. I want a sign change over here. So I multiply by a negative number. So 5 into 3 will give me minus 15. And m cube, no need to change because variable part is remaining the same. So the only multiple that I get over here is minus 3. So here I write minus 3, and on multiplication you will get minus 15m cube. Leave a line for sign change. This gets cancelled. Copy the remainder as it is. Baki ka dividend as it is. Okay. Now if you go to see, here there is no index, means your index is 1. This 1 is less than your divisor ka index, that is 3, and hence this entire thing becomes your remainder. You cannot proceed further. As soon as your remainder ka index becomes less than the highest index of the divisor, you will stop your division process. Okay, I don't have space to write down over here. You have to write it down in the notebook. Ye jo upar maine, okay, I'll highlight it in another color. This becomes your quotient, and the remaining thing, that is this, becomes your remainder. I hope this entire exercise is clear to you. Okay, practice set 10.2. And in miscellaneous exercise 2, there is one sum of division of polynomial. These entire thing, I will be doing it in my next video. Okay, so this video, I'm covering only your first practice set. I hope you have understood each and everything. Kuch bhi doubt rahega, you can see it again and get your doubts clear. Okay, whatever I have done on the screen in front of you, each and everything is there in your notes, which is provided in the class to all the students of Sir Rajan's tutorials. Okay, so you can refer the solution given over there. Remaining students who are not a part of SRT, you can just use the explanation which is done over here. Okay, thank you very much.
I hope everyone understood whatever I have taught in this particular video. Do write your views in the comment box, anything positives, negatives you see in the video. Do subscribe to the channel to get all the latest updates on this particular channel. You guys are free to share the video with even those students who are not a part of SRT so that everyone can benefit from it. Chalo, we will meet soon in our next videos. Till then, tata bye bye.